Yeah. You excited about tonight?
Yeah, I guess I'm excited about tonight.
Is this where you thought your life would be after 100 shows?
Actually, I thought my life would be a lot different after 100 shows.
Dark as shame, darling, dark as shame. Thank you for all the joy and pain. Picture show, second balcony, was the place we'd meet. Second seat, gold Dutch treat, you were sweet. Dark as shame, darling, dark as shame. Save those lies, darling, don't explain. I recall Central Park in fall, how you tore your dress, what a mess. I confess, that's not all. Dark as shame, darling, dark as shame. Thank you for walks down lover's lane. I can see hearts carved on a tree. Let us intertwine for all time, yours and mine. That was fine. Dark as shame, darling, dark as shame. Thank you for seeing me again. Though we go on our separate ways, still the memory stays for always. My heart says, dark as shame, dark as shame.
Yeah, that's how my life would have been. It would have been grand.
Gosh, why'd it have to be so weird?
Here we had the power go down at the studio a little bit earlier in the evening. Of course, all this equipment you see here in my backyard has been pulled together by our incredible crew here at Channel 3. Can I give them a big hand? Incredible! Incredible! Of course, a lot of things have been on the news since we last joined you last month here at Marty's Corner. Of course, the cast and crew weren't sure what to give me for my 100th anniversary. Now, 1 year, I guess, is wood if you give an anniversary gift. 25 years is silver. And all the guys pitched together and got me a six-pack of embalming fluid. So I don't know what that means exactly. Yeah, that's terrible. Authorities in New York City are testing the effects of potentially deadly gases that could be unleashed on the city during a biological attack. Now, Los Angeles, they're just having the authorities hang out in our control room during the show. I say, oh, wow, huh? We get some more beer for these people. Also in the news, Japanese scientists have unveiled the most human-looking female robot ever. She reacts so lifelike that she's already maxed out her visa, gained 30 pounds, and has a headache 5 days a week. So, it's all true. It's all true. Also in the news, a man who showed up at a sandwich shop wearing nothing but a ski mask will face several charges. Most people would be too embarrassed to show up wearing only a ski mask, but the man said he felt a little cocky. Is that bad? As I mentioned, we are celebrating our 100th show on our 12th anniversary. We have an incredible guest here on the show, a gentleman who is with us on our third show ever here on Marty's Corner, and he'll be back again here on the 12th anniversary. Comedian Barry Weisenberg is here tonight. Barry Weisenberg. Some 4 years ago, we had a gentleman on who was actually trying to open a club in the city of Uptown Whittier, actually, and this club was going to be a really cool swing club. At the time, he hadn't quite moved over from the, I guess, Orange County somewhere. And he brought on that night, 4 years ago, couples that were incredible swing dancers. And of course, he's been nice enough to come down tonight, and he's gonna not only talk a little bit about how the club is going down in Uptown Whittier, but also, again, he brought some incredible swing dancers from the swing dance troupe, I guess, down in Whittier. John Chris and the Swing Dance. Memory, is that right? Did I screw that up good enough for you guys? I just blew that, didn't I? Huh? It's the smoke that's doing it to me. And of course, last but not least, a band who joined us last year. These gentlemen, again, were nice enough to come down on a Saturday night. We got them set up behind me here in our backyard, and they're ready to perform. They've been playing some songs in a sound check, and we're looking forward to them performing here on the show. The Toast is here tonight. The Toast! And we want to go ahead and get to our first guest for the evening. Marty, real quick.
Yeah.
We actually have a surprise guest for you.
A surprise guest, yes.
Marilyn MANroe is here for you.
Oh, my God.
Hello, Marty. Now, look at that. Now, it's your 100th show, and I figured I would sing a special song to you, okay?
Great.
Are you ready?
Oh, I'm ready.
Okay, here we go. Happy 100th show to you.
Oh.
Happy 100th show to you.
Woo!
Happy 100th show. You little stud boy.
Well,
happy 100th show. To you.
Thank you.
Now, I'm really excited about being on your 100th show.
Yes.
You know what? I mean, all these people out here, you know what they're thinking?
No, what are they thinking?
They're thinking, I want to be loved by you, and nobody else but you. I want to be loved by you alone.
Cuckoo,
geechoo. So how do you feel about having your 100th anniversary show?
Well, it doesn't compare with you dressing up, Marilyn. You look great, by the way. I think your back is hairier than mine is. I can tell when I was touching it. Wow.
I think so.
I hope it doesn't affect, you know, anything else in my life, having you here on the show.
No, but pretty much you're never going to get any from
that. No, I don't think so.
All right, well, I think that you got some great guests on the show.
I do.
I don't want to keep you too
long. But you're not going to stay around?
Well,
there's some guys here that were looking at you, I think, earlier. I don't know. Maybe you want to... See, there they are right there.
Your director was checking me out.
Oh, God. Bless you so much, Al. Thank you so much. Al Katz, ladies and gentlemen, Al Katz! There goes the Emmy nomination right there, ladies and gentlemen, right there. We want to go ahead and again, introduce a gentleman who is, again, making his, I guess, maybe third or fourth appearance here on the show. Again, he's been with us for several anniversary shows. He's been with us for the Black and White show in 65. An incredible gentleman. He supported the show for more than 12 years by getting the show incredible comedians. We're so glad to have him back here. Can you please give a warm welcome to our good friend, Barry Weisenberg. Barry, come on out, Barry. Care to Barry.
How about a nice round of applause? 100 shows. Come on, give it up for Marty Shields.
And do me a favor, doesn't he have a great staff? Give it up for his staff too, yes? I do an old school style of comedy called one-liners. You guys ready for some one-liners? And I should tell you, I am tonight's Jewish comedian. Thank you very much. In case you don't know, it's very tough to grow up Jewish because we always had things that were different from other kids, even toys. By applause, you guys remember those toys years ago called Rock'em Sock'em Robots? Remember those? I had the Jewish version called Sue'em Screw'em Action Attorneys. So I gotta tell you guys, I am excited tonight. Spoke to my grandparents last week and I found out that my grandmother got breast implants. No, but she found a better substitute than saline or silicone, helium. So I said to my grandfather, I said, what do you think about grandma's new breasts? And he said, well. That's an anniversary joke, ladies and gentlemen. And I should tell you guys, I am tonight's celebrity comic. You guys remember the singer Don Ho? Anyone remember Don Ho? Yeah. Turns out I am his Jewish cousin, asshole. Again, thank you very much. So did you guys read this? I don't know if you guys saw this, but I read in Inc. magazine. It said that Riverside County is one of the top 10 entrepreneurial areas in the U.S. I read that and I thought, I didn't know meth labs were considered entrepreneurial endeavors. It is great to be here. I'll tell you, it's been kind of an odd day for me today. I was driving through Hollywood today. I got to ask you guys a question. Is it normal for a condom shop to have a blowout sale? And I'm actually lucky to be here tonight because I came here in a Geo Metro. It's a terrible car. To give you an idea, I was on the freeway last week. I had an accident and I rolled the car, did $7 worth of damage. And I'm glad I drove the car because I finally realized why Geo Metros have rear window defrosters. That's to warm your hands while you push the piece of crap to a repair station. I have a few minutes left. Let me tell you guys very quickly about my background. My name is Barry Weisenberg, and I've been working as a writer. All last year, I tried to make my living as a comedy writer. So far, I've sold two things, my house and my car. I've also been going on a lot of job interviews trying to get a better day job, which is a mistake because since I do comedy, I end up saying the wrong thing at the wrong time. I was on an interview a few weeks ago, and at the end of it, the guy said, by the way, this is a drug-free workplace. I said, good, because I'm really tired of paying for the damn things. Oh. And I got to tell you guys about my social life, because it's really bad, right? And everyone's giving me advice. Everyone's trying to tell me, they say, Barry, you're Jewish. Maybe you can meet someone at your place of worship. I said, okay. So I went to Hooters. You guys are a great crowd. My name is Barry Weisenberg. Good night. One more time, round of applause. Marty Shields, come on, give it up.
Oh, I'm gonna hold the microphone. Stay right here with me.
All right.
Stay right here. I got my own. Okay. Barry, real quick, let's look at the camera here, because, oh, there we are, right there. There we are. What do you remember most about putting on Marty's Corner about 12 years ago? What was it like back then?
You know, I remember that, and I've done other local cable shows. I rememberhow good your show was, how well run it was, how you ran it beautifully. And I remember being so nervous. You relaxed me so much, and I think I had a good night, and you were nice enough. You brought me back since. And also, as you guys know, the show has been Emmy nominated. What a phenomenal achievement. Yes?
Thank you. Thank you.
Easily, Marty, you're not only one of the nicest guys, you're one of the best hosts of any show I've seen in a long time. Give it up for Marty Shields. Yes.
We need to go away for a 3-minute break. We'll be right back. We'll hear from Barry Weisenberg one more time.
Thank
Barry Weisenberg!
Much. Marty Shields.
That's so joking.
You okay?
Yeah, I'm okay. Fine.
No problem.
Yeah, that was good. Thanks for having me on, by the way.
We have just received word that Marty's Corner is celebrating its 100th show. I understand that all the proper authorities have been notified and that congratulations are in order. And Marty, from Jim Patton to you, congratulations. It was great to be part of the early shows. And can you believe it? You're already at show 100. We look forward to the next 100. I know they're going to be great. Have a good one, my friend. Is my makeup lady around? Enough with this. Let's go on.
Back to a live Saturday night. Can the audience get loud one more time? Get loud, come on. Great audience here tonight. Great audience here live from my backyard of all places here in Hacienda Heights. Before we bring out our next guest, we want to do something very special. Some 12 years ago, in fact, tonight, August 20th, 12 years ago, 1993, we first started Marty's Corner. So we're actually on the actual date of the first show. And a gentleman who was with us back then, has been with us since for some 12 years. And tonight will be his last show. He will be retiring from Marty's Corner after 12 years of service, and we want to go ahead and bring him up here. He does not know about this. Our camera operator, Jack Rodriguez. Jack, come on up. Jack. Now, Jack, again, 12 years ago, what do you remember first about the first show from 12 years ago? What was it like?
Interesting.
Was it?
Yeah, it was.
Never the same, though, is it?
Never. It's just gotten better every year,
show. We want to go ahead and do something for you here on Marty's Corner. Of course, every month here on Marty's Corner, we actually do a top 11 list here on Marty's Corner, which is compiled by our home office in beautiful Baldwin Park.
Right.
Anybody from Baldwin Park? No, not a soul. And of course, we didn't want to go ahead and leave Jack out. Just a second here. Hold on. We want to go ahead and do something special for Jack. And of course, we decided to go ahead and give Jack his first top 11 list here on Marty's Corner. We don't know why he's retiring. We figure that he's doing a lot of work with his show, Touched by the Master, the award-winning show that he produces, which is a great show over at Channel 3 in Hacienda Heights. But again, we weren't really sure why he was retiring. So again, the top 11 list here on Marty's Corner, and we can bring that up, please, in the studio. Rather, top 11 reasons why Jack Rodriguez is retiring from Marty's Corner. Drum roll, please, Jeff. Number 11, 12 years at rock bottom is a man's limit. Number 10, banned from the show after accidentally injecting steroids. Number nine, he's going to be hosting the new Amish reality show, Pimp My Buggy. Number eight, going on tour with the Insane Clown Posse. That's right. Number seven on the list, Marty's Corner cameraman isn't the babe magnet he thought it would be. No. Number six, he's tired of being surrounded by crackers. That's right, huh? It's all true. Number five, turns out Frodo dropped the wrong ring into the fire, so it's back to Mount Doom. That's right, yeah. Number four, Marty's Corner doesn't really fit his vegan, gun-toting, nudist biker lifestyle. No, it does not. Number three, he's tired of asking me to bring little surprises hidden in his mustache. I don't know what the heck that means, all right. Number two, the Supreme Court ruled that working on Marty's Corner is cruel and unusual punishment. That's all true. And the number one reason Jack Rodriguez is retiring from Marty's Corner, he and Toto are going back to Kansas. And we're not done with Jack. Jack, hold this real quick. One more thing. On behalf of Marty's Corner and all the guys who worked with you for 12 years, presented to Jack Rodriguez, in appreciation for 12 years of service as a part of the Marty's Corner crew, August 20th, 1993 to August 20th, 2005. Ladies and gentlemen, Jack Rodriguez. Woo! All right, get back to work. All right, Jack Rodriguez, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you.
All right. Yeah.
One more time. Come on.
We will miss you, Jack. We will miss you. As I mentioned at the beginning of the show, again, some 4 years ago, this gentleman came down. He didn't know what he was getting into 4 years ago. He came down at the last minute to help us out. We needed some great guests, and of course, we contacted John down at Memories. And as I said, the club wasn't quite up to speed yet, but again, he was hoping and wishing that this club would be a success. Of course, it has been. An incredible dining and dancing experience down in Uptown Whittier. Can you please give the welcome to the owner of Memories, our good friend, John Chris. John, come on out. Thank you, sir. 4 years ago, we brought you down to the show down in Hacienda Heights. What do you remember most about coming down 4 years ago?
How impressed we were with the show.
Really?
We didn't know what we were expecting.
You didn't have to say it. Did you have a good time?
Yeah, it's a nice studio, great people, great crew. You really enjoyed it.
You brought down, again, two sets of dancers that showed us something that you do down at Memories. Besides everything else you do, you give lessons in swing dancing.
We do.
How's that working out? How is Memories going for you now?
Going great.
Is it?
Yeah.
What's the best thing about Memories if I want to come down to Memories on a Friday or Saturday night? What do you have got going on down there?
Well, the great music from the 1940s.
Right.
Great dancers, very friendly atmosphere. Everybody's very welcoming. And you can come in on any Friday, get a beginning class, whether you can dance or not. When you walk in, you'll be able to dance when you walk out.
You have live entertainment down at Memories. Tell us about that.
Every Friday night, we have some of the best bands in the Southern California. And anything ranging from 8 to 10-piece Dixieland jazz-type jazz bands to 15, 17-piece big bands playing all Frank Sinatra, Bobby Darin stuff.
Now, Memories is actually two stories. You got the downstairs level, but you got the upstairs level. How's that working out?
Oh, going great. You can teach some classes downstairs, and then everybody moves upstairs to do the dancing in the ballroom upstairs.
Now, you mentioned again the dancing. You have an incredible dance team that I guess represents Memories. Tell us about that. What's that all
we
about?
We do. A few years back, they started the Memories Swing Team, just some of the dancers that wanted to go out and promote dancing to other people. Spread the joy of dance, and it has evolved into some really great dancers with like 45 minutes worth of acts with 7 costume changes, and just very, very great group of people as ambassadors of swing dancing.
And an award-winning team, I'm guessing, here.
Absolutely, yes.
Now, how many people are in this dance troupe?
About 30, 32.
So yes. You pretty much fill up a stage when you need to. Where is Memories located if people want to get a hold of you? What's the best
We're in Uptown Whittier.
Yeah.
Yeah, corner of Philadelphia and Comstock.
And what's the phone number down to Memories?
562-693-7074.
And you also have a website. What's that?
We do. That's memoriesdancing.com.
Now, again, you have an incredible couple that teaches down there. Tell us a little bit about Essex
and Lee. We do. So proud of them and so happy to have them on our staff. It's Essex and Lee.
Right.
They met at the Orange County Fair, swing dancing.
Okay.
And been doing it ever since. And when we moved to Whittier, they approached me and said, can we teach some classes there? And they start off with 15 people in a beginning class, and then they started an intermediate class, an advanced class, and all those people moved up, and they got about a 98% loyalty factor of people that re-sign back up every 6 weeks, and now they have about 160 people on Monday nights for their classes, and just so happy to have them.
And affordably priced, correct? Affordably priced.
$55 That's for nothing. A six-week series, $10 for a general class.
And you can't beat that. In fact, they're here tonight, so let's go ahead and get out of our way. Let's bring on the Memory Swing Dancing. Come on out. Yeah. Come on, folks. Let's get out of there. Come on. Thank you. any of you guys working you guys out too much tonight. Real quickly, we want to get them catch their breath. First of all, as you can tell, it is warm out here on a Saturday night. First of all, Lee, could you introduce everyone that's dancing up here tonight?
This is my dance partner, Essex.
Essex, how are you doing? And to our left.
This is Kim and Sean.
Okay, great. How long have you been teaching down at Memories now?
We've been teaching as long as it's been in Uptown Whittier.
It's about 4 years now?
Yeah.
Again, you're talking large people, large groups of people coming in?
It keeps growing.
Large people or large people coming in?
Well, that's what all I meant. Sizes aren't coming in.
Big as me? Big as me coming in there?
Bigger.
Bigger than me? Is that possible? Wow. You're talking, you teach dances on dance classes on what nights? What nights do people come down?
We teach on Fridays and on Mondays. On Fridays, it's just one lesson, but on Mondays, it's a series.
A series of lessons? Okay. You said people as big as me come down. We want to go ahead and maybe go and teach me a few steps.
Sure.
So why don't you go and give the microphone to him and show me a couple of things real quick. What can I do?
All right, Marty. All right. I want you to start with, let's do something easy. Let's just go.
All right.
Let's go to the side. Go left, then to your right. Left. To your right. Lee's gonna help you out right there, okay?
God bless her.
All right, now we're gonna add a little something different.
Okay.
What we're gonna do is we're gonna take after a second, we're gonna go back, and then we'll go forward and side.
Back,
side, side, then back, back, side, side. Look at this, ladies and gentlemen, look at this.
Oh no.
Marty's getting this.
No, it's terrible.
Oh.
Not bad,
I like this, watch
no.
it. Just go side, back, side. Look at this. Ladies and gentlemen, oh, check them out.
Right there. Yeah! 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 No, it's terrible. I lost my backpack. Thank you so much. Okay, if I can do it, anybody can do it. Come here again for the Memories Dance Swing Game. And of course, again, if you want to go down and see the folks down at Memories again, Uptown Whittier, I think John Christ, I think he's ever come down. John Christ! We're going to go away for a 3-minute break while you guys go and dance as we get out. And one more time again, the swing dance team. Come on, tear it up, guys! Let's go! Give me something, Leo. Give me.
Here's a shout, counter marching right about, and those caissons go rolling along. Then it's high, high, he in the field of Hillary.
Welcome back here to Marty's Corner. As I mentioned at the beginning of the show, we have a band who joined us last year in Marty's Corner. These gentlemen, again, have been nice enough to come down on Saturday night. Again, they just kicked last show, and of course, we're expecting great things from them tonight, by the way. Are we all ready to go, ladies and gentlemen? Are we ready to go?
Are we ready?
Ready to go. Yeah! Ladies and gentlemen, can you please give a warm welcome to the Toes? Tear it up, gentlemen.
Lord, no.
On the toast, huh? Wow.
So cool. So cool. Nice one, nice
one. Real quick, Joel, tell
us, sir.
Again, a year ago you actually played at our show. What was it like and what's it like now?
Well, we were in the studio last time.
A little different.
A little different.
A little different environment.
Yes.
However, I love the pomegranate grove.
And I think Sean's having a good time about being here, isn't it, Sean, huh?
I'm having a great time.
Yeah. You guys are playing all over the place. What kind of gigs you got coming up?
On Tuesday evening, we're going to be in Long Beach at D Piazza's. That's this Tuesday, the 23rd of August. We'll be going on around 10 o'clock, but come at 8 because there's going to be live entertainment all evening. D Piazza's, Long Beach, this Tuesday.
You guys are playing. Go and keep the mic.
All right.
An incredible website. If they want to log on to your website, what's the best way to do that? What's your website over there?
Okay, we actually have two websites.
Two websites, not just one, two.
We have www.thetoast.net.
The last W, the three off.
Which is actually our official website.
Okay.
But then...
Three is what it is.
And then we also have... We have a MySpace address, which is The Toast LA. So if you look for The Toast LA, you'll find us on MySpace.
You're going to be doing another song. What song is that going to be?
We're going to do a song called Never Will Again. It's about a song. Well, it's definitely a song
about a song.
It's about a song. It's a song about a song.
About that beggar.
Oh, yeah. We're going to do a song called Beggar 2005.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, Toast, tear it up, guys. God help us. Help us, help us, help us. Man. Okay, gotcha.
Thank you.
day.
Down. Let's go. Let's go after break. Let's go. Same thing. Let's do it again.
One, two, three, four. Come to you live, as always, I said, from my house here. First time ever, huh? Wow, I think the alcohol is starting to get to me.
From the Pomegranate Grove.
Pomegranate Grove, that's right. It's not Avocado Heights, it's Pomegranate Grove here on Marty's Corner. Before we go out, we want to go ahead again and recognize, again, an incredible group that has been with me for more than 12 years. These gentlemen, as I said before, picked up all this gear about 7 o'clock this evening. Shoved it in their trucks, ran over here to my house, set it up. Can we hear it for the cast and crew here on Marty's Corner? And on behalf of Marty's Corner, we would like to go and present each one of our cast and crew here tonight with a lovely commemorative what is this? It's a plaque is what it is. Wow, it's getting late. I'm going to try to remember everybody's name in about 30 seconds. We have our director, John Garside. Our technical director, Robbie Hunt. Our engineers, Tim Keeler and Chris Hruby. In my garage tonight. Our camera operators, of course, Ron Monson. Patrick Stevens. Jack Rodriguez. Our announcer, Tony Ridley. Tony Ridley, thank you, Tony. Tony. Our DJ, Leonardo Flores. Leo, thank you so much, Leo. Our stage manager, Mandy Stevens. Thank you, Mandy. Our CG operator, Julian Strickland. Julian, thank you. Our lighting guy, Nathaniel Rodriguez. Thank you, Nathaniel. Our writers here on Marty's Corner, Jerry Renek. Thank you, Jerry. Our writer, Keith Landau on Marty's Corner. Our writer, Frank Atencio, here in Marty's Corner. Our audio engineers, Pat Woertink, here in Marty's Corner. And our other audio engineer, Wally Hagerty. Thank you, Wally. Have I forgotten anyone? I think I named off everyone, huh? Some guy in the corner, too. He gets one of these also. So we're going to put this down. And last, before we go, as I mentioned, Jack Rodriguez is retiring here on Marty's Corner, and in honor of Jack Rodriguez, we will be now referring to the annual Volunteer of the Year Award as the Jack. And our first recipient of the Jack Award goes to our director, John Garside. Get a shot of that. There you go. John Garside, ladies and gentlemen, John Garside.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you. It's an honor.
Thank you. Thank you. Let's get back here. Come on, let's get back out. Come on, follow me out. Let's go. That's it, John Garside.
John got Jack.
Or John Garside gets
John got Jack.
Yeah. Everybody's a comedian. And before we go out, we want to let everybody know again, a week from tonight, we'll be at the Emmy, so God willing, we'll bring back an Emmy to Hacienda High. Yeah!
And before we go out again, we want to thank all the fans who've been watching Marty's Corner for some 12 years here in Hacienda Heights and the surrounding areas, and of course around the world at www.martyscorner.com. On behalf of myself and all the folks here at Marty's Corner, take care, God bless, we'll see you in October, and the band plays, let's go, guys!
Baby and me went out late Saturday night. I had my hair piled high, my baby just looked so right. Well, pick up 10, gonna get you home to your mama. Don't know what I got for you, come on, pretty baby, let's get out of here right away. Well, we went to this place that didn't really look that bad. I had a whiskey on the rocks, changed a dollar for that jukebox. We had a border called right to that can, but all it played was Disco Man. Come on, pretty baby, let's get out of here right away. We're gonna rock this town, rock it inside out. We're gonna rock this town, rock it inside out. Let's rock, rock, rock till we're probably gonna rock till we're probably gonna rock till we're probably gonna rock this town, rock it inside. Come on, Ace, bring us out one, baby. Well, there's real square Cadillacs in 1974. Yeah, look at me once, look at me twice, look at me again, there's gotta be a fire.